I mean, arise? When did people think these foods are just not the right colour? I need a bit more pizzazz in my
Well, lunch. I think you only need sort of imagine, don't you? I mean, you know, right. You're pounding maize in Mexico, which is where this thing sort of started, and
right.
and a few of these beetles that live, they're all over the place.
Right.
And accidentally, and while you're pounding it, it goes all a rather beautiful pink colour.
Wait a minute.
And your husband says, "I like this new maize cake, this pink polenta."
They didn't start like crushing animals and slowly work their way down to beetles. They're like crushing a squirrel. No, that's no good. That colour. Next animal.
That's what I'm making.
Oh look, you set your buzzer off.
That's what I imagine.
Also, they didn't say, "I love this pink polenta." Mm. They said, "The pink polenta, I love it."
So you think that...
I want some pink polenta.
So you think this happened after the Spanish colonisation of Mexico?
Yeah. Alan!
We got you, that was a good one. That's off.
Are you telling me the Incas taught like Oxbridge graduates? Yeah.
Well, how do they talk to
I'm just going up to finish off Machu Picchu. Can you help me with these stones?
It was really the Aztecs we were concerned with. But in either case, never mind.
You ever felt like your weapon's not big enough?
No. Nonsense.
No.
So, no. Let's move from bugs. Orange. What's his surname? It's probably the same root as Göring. My prep school tailors were called Göring, funnily enough.
Really?
We get our uniforms made, yeah.
You're a tailor. You're a tailor. For like a suit you wear when you're five.
There was.
Were you born in the 1850s?
No. You have.
I shall measure up, young sir. Your shorts and cap.
Particular outfitter. It was the school outfitter.
All right.
Which was a tailoring shop, an outfit school outfit
which,
called Gorringer's.
Which side does young sir dress on? There's nothing really to worry about.
You should know that. It's written on the toilet wall.
Please. Oh, heavens, why did I even mention that?
That's you want to get measured up for sure.
Lord,
would sir like to wear a cravat on the cross-country run?
Oh, you're all such beasts. Yeah. Well, anyway, Göring is a splendid English surname.
I suggest, a cummerbund for geography.
I say, oh. You rather like this pink polenta.
Right, gentlemen, bombs away. Alan, have you heard about the Mexican kamikaze squadron?
Kamikazes, like that.
That's right, only Mexican. And,
I care not for myself, only my country.
Very good indeed. Very good indeed.
For the emperor.
Andale. You said that. Because that brings me to my next question, which I'm going to address to Rich. Which comedian went and dropped an atomic bomb on Japan?
That would mean, basically, which comedian bombed in Japan. That would have been me.
Did you bomb in Japan?
I'd bombed so horribly in Japan that I...
In front of an English-speaking audience?
No, Japanese-speaking audience. I think I put my finger on what went wrong. That had a lot to do with it.
No, a comedian member of, what you might call a troupe of comedians.
One of the Stooges.
No, better known than this.
Abbott and Costello.
Why, you knucklehead. You dropped that atomic bomb on Japan. What do you want to do that for? Why, you're at war.
They'd never have won the war if those blokes had had a plane.
Oh, Harpo could actually talk in real life.
No. Oh, now you've shattered all
I read his autobiography.
No.
He spent the first 15 years of his life nicking stuff. And he's really proud of it.
They all did. They were gangsters in New York, big hoodlums.
The Three Stooges are flying planes, and they're the gangs of New York.
The gangs of New York. He's got the stove.
We're going to kill you if you don't give me that money.
And he had a long career as an off-dinner speaker later on, Harpo, because he could just stand up and say, unaccustomed as I am.
Hey! A lot of the early 20th century gangs in New York were Jewish. I was in Dutch Schultz, people like that. And right up to Meyer Lansky and Bugsy Siegel.
I think that a lot of the Scorsese oeuvre would be a lot nicer if people had horns and... You know, didn't they? They had a funny hat. Yeah. Hey, Johnny, what's you gonna go do? You think I'm funny how? I'm gonna play this f***ing harp over here. I amuse you.
She just cut.
Have you had
no,
the fugu?
I've never been to Japan.
You're so tall, you'd be like Godzilla. They'd be... Aye!
Steven Freyo!
Meet the fly!
You'd be rampaging through downtown Tokyo.
Go to New Zealand!
I love the Boy Scouts. We went to Nam.
It's actually said to be an American invention, the Boy Scout movement. It's more than really a British, although it's said to be Baden Powell by many. There was a man called Seaton who founded a movement called the Woodcraft Indians.
Did you go in a helicopter gunship?
He had a little waistcoat with the palm strapped in, with the doors playing really loudly.
Now, boys, if you see anybody wearing black pyjamas, you run towards them and you press that button there.
Dim, dim, dim.
Boom! You got your woodcraft, you got your killing gooks.
You got your napalm waistcoat, too.
Well, there you are. You've spoiled it. Oh, what's right. Red and sits in the corner? A naughty strawberry.
Very good.
What's green and sings? Elvis Parsley.
Now, the smuts. Smut fungus, Ustilaginales, or something similar, is found in Mexico, in particular where it's prized as a food.
Why did the mushroom go to the party? He was a fun guy.
There's another argument for it, that it's the website in Tokyo for all the Japanese men who are crazy about Virginia Bottomley.
Bottomley! Loosely made from, also scientists suppose.
So he reckoned he was going to be famous by giving his name to the most common stuff, and we've
no one's ever heard of him.
He's got such a good name for a scientist who discovered things, and probably had a wonderful accent, just the same as the man who used to go, incredible, Tyrannosaurus Rex.
And he said Heinz Wolf.
Yes, it's like Heinz Wolf, exactly.
It's a very elegant solution to my problem. Yes. It's always elegant. But while still in Rome, how did Roman emperors order the death of a gladiator? No, you're right. It was a trap. No, they didn't put their thumbs down. Put their thumbs up.
Take him out and kill him.
Well, this is
a gladiator. It is over for you.
Fourth place was awarded to a Cuban postman called Felix Carvajal, who rather sweetly
delivered the post on the way around.
I have a letter for you.
That's so like
from Cuba.
It's so like your famous Mexican accent, but yeah.
He does look like Eddie Fox in The Day and the Jackal.
But he said, it's going to cost you a lot of money.
Doesn't it?
Eddie Fox, the only man with a bicep in his face.
Wallace, I'm going to have to abdicate.
I was in a play in Chichester years ago, 20-odd years ago. It was the first play I was ever in. And he was in another play, but I got to know the DSM, as they're called, the Deputy Stage Manager, very well. And she'd not met him, and he suddenly appeared and put a hand on either shoulder and leant into ear and said, if we do go to bed together, it'll be strictly on my terms. Hell of a pick-up line, isn't it?
Ed was one of these guys who says that he just upstairs into space and suddenly says something. And he was sitting in a dressing room, possibly at Chichester again, actually, and he said, I'm so glad there are no homosexuals in this company. Everything just looks at him. The other lot in the Antony and Cleopatra play are an absolute fleet of Berties.
1979. And a judge, rather splendidly named Judge Jack Love of Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Judge Love,
exactly.
I stand before you, Judge Love.
You are in the court of love. Yeah, anyway. He did exist.
Thanks, Judge Love. I go to prison for you, Judge Love.
So fingers on buzzers. Please, who can hum
the most listened to tune in the world.
I'm above it.
Yes.
Oh, dear!
You've been doing so well.
The shame, the shame. Go, diddly,
diddly, diddly, is the right answer! Do you know who wrote it?
Someone in Finland.
No, Spanish. A Spanish composer. A genuine Spanish composer. He then tried to sell the Statue of Liberty to an Australian, and that's where it fell down. But he went...
Oh, look, come on, mate.
He didn't even have the keys.
How am I going to get it home? Where's the guarantee?
Who do you think invented Greco-Roman wrestling?
Greeks and Romans.
Oh!
Now all you have to say is Mr. Wrestling.
No, actually, it was the French, and they thought they'd give it a classical sort of thing.
You want two... some men rubbing against each other.
Thank you. But why would they import them? What do they need them for?
They're very good at cricket, the yes. Australian one.
The Australian camels are actually much fitter than the
Oh, look, we like Saudi. Sports.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a big outdoors.
No, they don't. They don't use them to race. They don't use them for transport. They use the camels they import for
food.
Freedom. Food for meat. Camel meat.
They eat
yes.
them. They tell them they're going them. To have a lovely yeah. life yeah. of camel race. You'll love it over there, mate. Away you go. Good luck. Give us a call when you've won your first race.
At the bar, especially you're at the bar, and there's someone at the back who taps the bloke next to you and says, "Get us a couple of pints, will you?"
When you're at the bar and someone leans forward with money and they get served first just because they're on television.
Yeah.
Mr. Fry, go away, scum.
Make way, make way. No. Lord Fry. No. Come for a port.
Here he is, on his bicycle with his hockey stick.
Right, make way.
Here, Mr. Frown.
Clear that table. Get up. Get out. Can anyone here sing the Lord's Prayer in Latin? No. Well, out. All of you.
Let's take the word cool. When did it first mean like fashionable? Do you think?
60s beatnik poet era.
Hitler.
Oddly enough, it was the year Hitler came to power, 1933, but I don't think that's quite relevant.
These new uniforms are cool.
Bizarrely.
So this is Christmas.
I'm joining the Nazi party. They're cool, Daddy-o.
Cool, Daddy-o.
Bizarrely, it was 1933.
And besides, I have no choice.
Yeah. I burned out a Reichstag. Cool. Jazz Nazis.
It was the West Coast School of...